buying and selling security over the internet is known as online security. During online trading, an investor makes an order to a broker online. The broker then executes the order to the ordinary users. It is continuously growing and has a huge market potential. Online trading in India started in February 2000 when a couple of brokers started offering an online trading platform for their customers. Objectives of online security trading: to attract new capital by means of issuing security, to transfer real estate into financial assets, to invest money for short or long term periods with the aim of deriving profitability, to do commercial functions, to determine size of security. Benefits of online security trading: low fees, as there is very low fee. One of the clearest advantages of online trading is the reduction in transaction cost and high fees associated with traditional brick and mortar brokerage firms. As personal brokers charge high fees, and this fee depends on the area of expertise and years of experience. Information and tools: most web-based trading platforms give access to sophisticated informative tools for trading. These tools and a lot of self-education can make wise investments. 24/7 trading: the stock market is open anytime, anywhere you can trade. No financial minimums, there is no limitation for financial investment. One can start buying penny stock with less than $100. More control and flexibility: traditional brick and mortar brokerage might require appointments either online, over the phone or in person. Just to initiate a trade, there is no problem in online security trading. Ability to avoid brokerage bias: by taking trading into own hands, one can eliminate brokerage bias. While sometimes other men of broker gives financial advice that benefits the broker, such as in the form of commission or specific mutual funds and other brokers. Access to online tools: in the world of online trading, a lower cost does not necessarily mean a cost broker. Many of today's online trading companies offer customers an intensive suite of tools to help optimize trades. Besides, there are some disadvantages of online security trading. Easier to invest too much too fast. Because online trading is so easy, basically only push a button, there is a risk of making poor investment choice or over investment. So there are some remedies for this. Online investors can protect themselves by understanding the stocks they are buying and setting up safeguards in fast paced markets. Placing a limit order on account is one way to control what buy and how much of it. No personal relationship with brokers: by and large, online traders are on their own. They don't have a broker to help them navigate the uncertain waters of the stock market. For this, we can say SPC trading are a great place to start. Public companies are required to submit detailed information to the SPC on a regular basis. Potential conflicts and risk factors: the public can access this information online. Addictive nature: trading stock can be like gambling for some people. The trader speculates on the result of some things, such as the company's performance, and then bets money that the speculation will be correct. Sometimes investors choose short-term trading strategies that involve investing in risky stock, offering the potential for large gains but also significant losses. Internet dependence: the online trading is totally dependent on internet. For this, we can say the SEC recommends investors have a backup plan in case they are cut off from the internet. Many firms allow customers to use a touchtone phone according to system, ordering system, and others even provide live brokers to take orders. Buying errors due to customer missteps: with online trading, to simply assume a trade was not completed can charge money. Investors who believe their trade was not completed might make a trade again and again, and investing regularly. For this, we can check with Brugger about how to verify cancel pains. The SEC wants that simply receiving an electronic cancellation receipt is not necessary sufficient evidence that the pay was actually cancelled. The process of online security clearing. First, either the place an order or go on portal or stockbroker, then broker transfers to gold, then wait confirmation, broker settlement to exchange, deposit redemption, and then shares transfer. BSE online trading. The Bombay online trading system is online trading system for trading in securities. The system is operational at Bombay Stock Exchange. The premier stock exchange is the Southeast Asian region. It is one of the few stock trading systems around the globe which handles hybrid mixed mode of trading, order driven as well as quote driven. Main objectives of gold are to increase trade capacity of the stock exchange, improve market transparency, remove unsuitable trades, and delay reporting, promote fairness and speedy matching. Why online trading entered late in India? The Indian stock exchange and broking houses have been very slow in moving their online transactions. The prime reason has been a lot of government regulations, poor internet connectivity, related issues are the most important technological factors. Many other issues like security backup and recovery procedural costs are also acted as a reason behind this. Major players in online trading: Sharekhan.com, ICICI.com, Motilal Oswal, Indiabulls, Angel Broking, Reliance Money, 5paisa.com, DSP Merrill Lynch, Kotak Securities, BOD Securities. At last, we can conclude, online security trading is becoming increasingly popular as it brings convenience, simplicity and speed to consumers. Regardless of the method employed, fraud is a global phenomenon that is constantly evolving in order to exploit security gaps. It also possesses a migratory nature, targeting countries which have less sophisticated security infrastructure. As there are so many problems and disadvantages while using online security trading, but in business scenario, e-business is moving upward regularly. There are so many reasons behind this as discussed above. So we cannot ignore the utility and importance of online security. Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your presentation. We wish you a great future ahead. Now, I would like to invite on the stage our next researcher, Mr. Pratik Deol, for his presentation. Please welcome Mr. Pratik Deol.
Good evening, one and all. It's glad to know that there was nobody to present the law with regard to the e-commerce, and that gives me a leverage and gives me an advantage to have a discussion with all of you with regard to the e-commerce laws and India. And when we come to this particular topic called as e-commerce, in the present day world and the previous sessions, it has been highlighted that e-commerce is now on its growth. But surprisingly, till this particular date, there is neither any law which exists with regard to the same. There is neither a proper definition of the same which is attached to it. If you try to look through any of the provisions of any of the law, you will not find the definition of the term e-commerce. However, the FDI, the Foreign Direct Investment Policy of 2014, issued by the Department of Industrial Promotion and Policy, Ministry of Commerce, Government of India, there is a small definition, not definition, an explanation has been given with regard to the term e-commerce, which basically in involves transactions online between consumers and business, or business and consumers, or business to consumers. These are the various types of transactions which are available with regard to your e-commerce. And this is the processing which happens with regard to your e-commerce. You would see that when we are trying to buy a product in an online way, this is what is very key or very important with regard to the transaction which is to be done in an online way, that is delivery, payment facilitation, supply chain and service management. You would see the examples of the online service providers have been taken here. I will not take those names like Flipkart and all that, and the way in which the transactions happen. But this is the backdrop, you can say this is the managerial aspect in which actually an e-commerce transaction is going to happen. This is the new thing is with regard to the marketplace model. Now the 100% FDI is being introduced with regard to the e-commerce to the automatic route. That means now there is no requirement of any approval from the Foreign Investment Promotion Board of the Government of India, and anybody through this particular route can make a direct investment with regard to the foreign direct investment. And this is where the e-transactions are going to happen with regard to the portals where there will be a buying and selling of products in an online mode. This is what is called as your marketplace model. These are the models which you will see being updated about these things for the whole day. M-commerce is something new. Why? Because now people have started making transactions through the applications which are existing on the mobiles. You are able to book a cab through an app. You are able to get a product through an app on your mobile. You are able to know your bank balance through an app on your mobile. You are able to do transactions through an app on your mobile. Because of this particular feature within your mobile, besides having good snaps and good music, the feature of a smartphone which helps you to transact is a newer business model which has come up. The rest are known to you. Whether there is a transaction between two business entities, there is a transaction between a business and a customer. Customer-to-customer transactions like OLX, in which you are going to sell your products to another customer. You yourself are a customer and there is somebody else who is going to buy your products. And it's going to happen in an online way. Business to business and then to the customer. That means from wholesale to retail and then from retail to you. The last one is customer to business. We find it tough to relate that how can it be possible that there is a transaction from a customer to the business. It seems very tough. But it is possible because of the simple fact that the moment there is a feedback form which we all are also expected to fulfill, and there is a feedback form which is given in your online transactions also, that helps the business to understand, as the previous speaker was trying to highlight, to take the perceptions of the customers, their demands, the drawbacks that they are looking forward to, and that they want the redressal of the same. These are the e-commerce models. This one is the latest. This and this one. This has revolutionized as far as the aspect of e-commerce is concerned. This is where my area comes up, because I am being a law practitioner. I am going to talk about the various laws which we are not even aware of, and I am thankful to the conference that even I came to know that because of the e-commerce, there are so many laws which are coming into the interface with regard to a single e-commerce transaction. When we buy a product online, let's say if you are planning to buy a shop, if you are planning to shop a pair of shoes of Reebok in an online way, to let's say from the Flipkart, did we ever think that these are the areas of law which may come into interface with regard to our transaction? I will name some of the laws. Company law, consumer protection law, Indian contract law, Indian penal code, IT law, IP law, intellectual property law, which is my area of specialization, and the taxation law. Hold on. Move back, please. Company law. There are companies which are established and they are doing their business online. But there is a requirement that they have to fulfill in order to establish a company, the law which is there in India, that is Companies Act 2013. There is a requirement of the number of directors, their data and details with regard to the same. Consumer protection law. We often find it very tough that in case we find a defective product by the virtue of an online transaction, how are we going to have any kind of a result? Do we have any remedy in that particular case? If you are going to buy a product online which does not have any value, economical value attached to it, then there is no remedy under the law. But for the consumer protection law, if there is any defect in good or in service and there is a transaction, there is a monetary transaction that happens between you and the provider to you, then you have a remedy under the law, under this particular law titled as Consumer Protection Act of 1986. So you don't need to feel helpless in case you have bought a product in an online transaction. Next is the Indian Contract Act. You must have been, as in the previous sessions it was talked about, that we accept and we install a software without realizing the fact that we are agreeing to each and every terms and conditions which are imposed upon us by the other side, and there is no place for you to have any kind of a bargaining in the underlying situation. That is called as the gift wrap agreement. There is a shrink wrap agreement in the virtue of which when you buy a product, only after that you are able to understand what are the stipulations attached to it. In the Penal Code, as it was highlighted, because of the less availability of borders in an e-commerce transaction, it is very tough to find the actual culprit and to trace him. But there is a law in this, I'm assuming the time, IT law. There was a point raised that there is no law. No, there is a law which exists with regard to the e-commerce, and that is information technology law. That is dealing with your cyberspace. However, it is tough to find out the technical issues and to correlate it to the law. That is why it becomes tough to move under the IT law. I will not take much time, I will just highlight the intellectual property law. There are websites which are having their trademarks under their web domain on their web page. The moment somebody is trying to make a copy of the same through the transactions either in the web name or on their web page is a violation of the copyrighted design. It's a protection which is given to the web page so originally designed. That is a violation. The moment the person tries to make a copy of the same, it is called as the copyright infringement. It's just one of the issues of IP which is involved. And taxation. It is very tough to tax the entity which is actually doing an online transaction, because you don't know where the person is actually doing business and who is actually transacting with whom. That's another difficulty which comes with regard to your online transaction. And these are some sets of laws which are involved with regard to your e-commerce. Next slide, please. Thus, it can be inferred that transacting online seems simple, but there are a lot of laws, and I would like to say there is a lot of need for the awareness amongst the persons who are doing online transactions that there are laws which are there to protect them and to enforce their rights. Thank you so much, panel. Any queries?
Any queries from the audience, please?
We don't have a law because we have not felt the bad impact of it on that massive scale. There was a recent Bangladesh case in which what happened is the governmental bank, the Bangladesh bank itself, had a fiasco. There was a company named as Swift which was providing an online security transactions to their business. But what happened is because the security was managed by the bank personally, when the fiasco actually happened, the company said, we are not liable, it's your cyber security issue and not ours. Even our Indian banking system doesn't have that kind of a secured transaction, and it seems very tough to us, but for the hackers, it's way too easy hacking even the governmental websites and even the governmental sensitive information. Because the moment there will be a big fiasco, you will respond. There are countries with different attitudes. There are some countries which have proactive response technique, but there are some which are going to depend only on an event, and they will look forward to solutions. But as far as the law is concerned, there are a group of laws, but not a single consolidated law with regard to the same. Because there are so many dimensions attached, it is equally going to be tough to have one law. Because you have so many issues, tax is the issue, labor law is the issue, intellectual property law is the issue, you have company law is the issue. It's very tough to have these, to have one law on this particular issue. Yes. Thank you. Any other questions?
Thank you very much, sir, for sharing your reflective knowledge with us. Young vision is you for a very bright future. Now, this is the time to encourage the spirit of next researcher. For that, I would like to invite Mr. Gaurav Shukla, sir, for oral presentation on the stage. Sir, please.
Ultimate paper, because free gives us paper. But now the email has taken place.
Now I will change it to next day. This is the online marketing, because online marketing is a synonym of email marketing. So, what are the difference between the digital marketing and the internet marketing? So, most of you use it for interchangeably, but there is a whole lot of difference between the digital marketing and the internet marketing. Because digital marketing is an umbrella term. And in the manager portion, you can say that digital marketing is a wide concept and the internet marketing is a subset or a narrower concept in the digital marketing. And this is a beautiful equation. I think most of us don't like this beautiful equation. Now we should go to the next one. Look, we the Indians are lagging behind by China in terms of population as well and in terms of internet using as well. We have to be there when it is the time.
We can come to the conclusion part, please.
Now, in the end, I would like to ask 5 questions for you. You can say yes or you can say by this or that. I will ask 5 questions to you. And if you say yes or no, then I will say what you do. Well, I want to ask that how many of you use smartphone? I think most of you are. And how many of you use Paytm or the online site for buying? I think most of you. But have you used the page 2, 3 or 4 of Google while searching? Because when you go on Google, you go on. And last question. Have you ever get the promotional messages from the site like the Meta.com or Somebody.com? But these are the internet marketers who are just getting in your way and get that.
Any questions? Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your insights with us today. We wish you a very bright future ahead. Now, last but not the least, I would like to invite our last research analyst, Portia Aslam, on the stage for a oral presentation. Please welcome Ms. Portia Aslam.
Empowered RBI to regulate and supervise the payment and settlement system in the country.
Now moving on to the next issue, I'm doing the resident is short and manner as far as the manner is concerned. So we're talking about e-contact. Now everybody knows that it comes under the purview of in a contact that being consumed. Now there are certain essentials and one of these main essentials is majority of case. Now in the e-contact, there is no way that we can certify that the person trading is a major in case. So therefore the person forces needs to explicitly mention it in the form that the person with whom it is trading is a major engage. Now coming to the third point on the issue is the copyright issue or the idea. Now as the earlier the speaker sir has already explained that what it is there and it talks about the copyright trademark infringement which basically deals with it. So there I'd like to quote two three cases along with some sections. Now here as in Satya Mukhove was the 59th solution. Supreme Court has already stated a domain name according to a provision services within the meaning of the Section 2, Subsection Z of the Indian Trade Act and as per Section 63 and 3 of the Copyright Act which states that pictures, sound, literary work and other work are protected from being copied and without the permission of copyright holder. And also in the Himalaya drug case versus Comerce there was it was said that it is like punished as well as penalized. Or he can be partly punished and partly penalized. Talking about the last and the foremost issue, that is the advertising issue. Now there is the absence of single category law which guides and regulates the patterns of designing of the advertisements which are floating all about the e-commerce. The lead times, although there is ASCI, that is Advertising Standards Council of India, which is a non-statutory and voluntary association, but then there is no certain stat or a kind of a association which can regulate to it because at times the government as a whole keep aside the orders of ASCI. And these kinds of advertisements are not only this misleading, they call it, but also at times options and cheap, which become very awkward. Now jumping up to the conclusion, I will say that e-commerce portals should lay terms and conditions which are specific and not generic, depending upon the nature of goods and services. E-commerce care should also ensure the retail efforts to prevent unauthorized transactions. Now here I would like to mention one thing, that there is no common single law. There is the absence of statutory law. Moreover, there is the absence of law which can govern the advertising kind of advertisements. So the ones which are not conforming with the bar or with the kind of standard of the information, we can go with it. And further at the last, I can say there is also a need of this statutory law which can govern the e-commerce because it's more likely to be the future of tomorrow. And such issues can be known further in the growth of e-commerce. Thank you.
We have to move outside the वहाँ हम लोग अपना ग्रुप फोटोग्राफ भी हो गए और अभी जो हमारे को अपने दोनों फ्लैग बहुत ही बेहतरीन चीज़ों फ्लैग थे उनको हमारे को रिस्पेक्ट से देने हैं। तो इट्स अ ग्रेट मोमेंट, दिस इज थर्ड डे, फाइनल डे, आई होप यू एंजॉयड होल डे, इजंट इट, इजंट इट, इजंट इट, माय फाइनल वर्ड, फाइनल वर्ड, माय फाइनल वर्ड, चलते चलते मेरी याद करना कभी अलविदा ना करना, कभी अलविदा ना करना, कभी अलविदा ना करना। थैंक यू, थैंक यू, सी यू अगेन। बट दिस इज अ लाइफ कॉन्सेप्ट, इमीडिएटली वी हैव टू मूव आउट एट द स्टेट नाउ। आई नाउ, ओ वेल, दैट्स टाइम टू रिजल्ट।